Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how the Flow Layout Manager works in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Well, the Flow Layout, it places components in a row sized at their preferred size. If the horizontal space in the container is too small, then the flow layout class uses the next available row. So we'll need a frame. I'm just going to paste what I had previously. So JFrame frame equals new JFrame, frame.set default close operation, JFrame exit on close, set your preferred size, and then frame.set visible true. To set up a frame or other container class with a flow layout, we use a certain function called set layout. And then we pass in a new layout manager. So new flow layout. So by default, frames use a border layout. So this time we're setting this with a flow layout. Now we'll need to add some components to this frame to demonstrate the effects of a flow layout. So let's create some buttons. So J button, we'll call this button one equals new J button. All right, so I'm going to show you guys a shortcut too for creating components. So let's say that we're adding this button to the frame. So frame.add, then we say button one, right? One shortcut that we can do just to save time is that instead of calling this by name, we can just say new J button and pass this in to the frame when we add this. And then we can give this like a number if we wanted to. So this will create a new J button for us. All right, so one problem that you might run into is that sometimes these components don't always display if you set the visibility to true before you actually add the components. So actually, if we were to move this window, this button appears. So I'm just going to set the visibility at the very end so we don't run into any problems. So then this should display right away. There it is. All right, let's create a bunch of buttons to demonstrate this. So I'm going to copy this line of code where we create a new J button and add this to the frame, maybe like 9 times or so. So we'll call this button 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right, so we should have 9 buttons now, and they're all centered within the top row. So with flow layouts, if they run out of room within their first row, the components will be pushed down to the next row, kind of like this. Pretty sweet, right? So it's kind of like a waterfall or something. It's flowing like water. So we can also set an alignment for these components. So when you pass in a new flow layout, you can type in flow layout dot, and if you want this to start on the left, you can say leading, and there's a few options here. So now what these components do is that they stick to the left-hand side, they're leading. And if you were to expand this frame, they will stay in the top left corner. And then when you compress this frame, they will be pushed down. So the default is actually center. So we should see no change with what we had previously, where they will all stay in the center. And there's also trailing as well, so let's switch this to trailing. And now they will stick to the right-hand side. And if you were to compress this frame, they will be pushed down. You can also set the horizontal and vertical gaps between the components too. So I'm going to change this back to center. To set some spacing, you pass in some integers when you actually create a new flow layout. So the first number is the horizontal spacing, and the second number is the vertical spacing. So if we set these both to 0, these buttons are going to be touching, which they are. So let's set the vertical spacing to 10. So now we have 10 pixels worth of space around the components. And then let's set the horizontal spacing to also 10. So now we have extra spacing between these components. With layout managers, you can also add layout managers to panels. So let's create a panel and add all of these buttons to our panel, then add the panel to the frame. So we'll need to create a panel and set this up with a flow layout manager. So let's create a panel, jpanel. We'll call this panel equals new jpanel. Then let's set a size for this panel as well. So panel.set preferred size. We need to pass in the dimensions by saying new dimension. Let's say this is 250 by 250. And let's set the background color so we can better see this. Panel.set background. Let's say light gray. So color.lightgray. All right, so then with these buttons, we're going to be adding these to the panel in place of the frame. So one shortcut that you can do, if you're using the Eclipse IDE, select all of the code that you want to edit. If you want to replace a certain word, you can go to Edit, Find Replace. I'm going to replace the word frame with panel, and then replace all. All right, so we're going to be adding these buttons to the panel. However, we still need to set the layout manager for the panel because I forgot to do that. So panel.setLayout. And then we are passing in a new flow layout. New flow layout. And actually, by default, panels already use a flow layout, but I'm just doing this again for teaching purposes. So this panel has a flow layout, and we're adding all of the buttons to the panel this time. And then we need to add the panel to the frame. So frame.addPanel. So this is what this looks like now. This panel is acting as the container, and since these buttons ran out of room within the first row, the next set of buttons got pushed down to the next row. And if we were to change the width of this panel, it's going to push the buttons down even further, down further rows. So let's set the width to now 100. So these buttons are pushed down even further because this panel is using a flow layout, just like what the frame was using in the previous example. So that's the basics of the flow layout manager. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the flow layout manager in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.